welcome back to my channel and thank you so much for clicking on this video. You guys, it's been such a long time since I've been on camera and I am so happy to be back on camera after such a long time, and I'm so excited for this video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Nelly. I'm so glad to have you. Please don't forget to subscribe and like this video. So you guys, like I was saying, I'm so excited for today's video. Today I am doing a foundation review. Hold on, like this foundation, I've seen it so much on Instagram and on TikTok and I've never used it before, but it's not a new foundation. I think it's been on the market for quite some time. Let me show you guys what I'm talking about. So the foundation that I'll be reviewing today is this Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation. This is a matte foundation and I know it looks so dirty because I've actually had it for quite some time, but I have not used it. And it was so hard for me to actually get a shade because you guys know it's Corona, you're not allowed to have testers in stores. So I literally had to sit there with this foundation and my Maybelline foundation, the one that I use every day, my favorite foundation. And I had to try to match the shades. I don't think I did a good job. And that's the saddest part about it. I feel like this shade is pretty light. Like, even without me applying it on my face, if I just hold it against my skin tone like this, it looks pretty light. But it's too late now. It's really too late to turn back now. So I had to use it and perhaps, like, really try to bronze my face so that I can really look balanced. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, so I'm just going to go online quickly and I'm going to get you guys some tea on this foundation. Let me try to look up any information that I can find on Google. Under description on the Wet n Wild website, it says, your skin only better. Our new high-performing skin-perfecting foundation underwent a major road testing under several different photo lighting conditions to deliver flawless camera-ready makeup each and every time. Especially made with a matte, light diffusing complexion to give your skin hashtag non-filter perfection. So they say that this foundation is a high performing breakthrough formula featuring a light adjusting complex to help prevent white cast in photos. Okay, that's good. It says that tested under several light conditions with and without the use of a flash. Okay, so judging by that description, I think basically this foundation is supposed to just look really good on camera and on film, which is very good since you guys are going to be seeing this through me filming and not like in person. So we're really going to see if it's going to perform. And then under benefits, it says, goodbye photo flashback, tested under several light conditions with top smartphone models. Apparently this foundation has been tested under these types of conditions. It's been tested under clear blue sunlit skies, outdoors PM, indoors PM. I suppose like they mean like outdoors in the evening and indoors in the evening. And it's also been tested under electronic flash, fluorescent light, which is what I'm using right now. So that's also going to be a good testing condition for the video. Bathroom light, nightclub light. So it says a panel of women were tested in a controlled environment simulating 7 different lighting scenarios with professionally applied concealer, foundation and or powder, and took their own selfies with top smartphones. The majority of the study participants said that the resulting picture was no flashback or flawless or perfect. I'm going to be testing that out, y'all. According to their website, they have 20 shades of this foundation and I took the shade caramel. Like I said earlier, since I'm a caramel in my Maybelline 24 hour, well, the 3rd hour Superstay foundation, and since I couldn't really check out any testers in the store because they aren't because of Corona, so I tried to take the same shade that I would take in my Maybelline foundation. So let's get started with the application of this particular foundation. I have my damp beauty sponge over here and I'm just gonna shake it prior to me applying it on my face. Oh yeah, okay, before I go in with the foundation, I'm gonna go in with my Nivea. You guys know I love this stuff, especially if I'm gonna be wearing a matte foundation because my skin is a bit on the dry side. And I'm really gonna keep my application process, like my makeup routine, the same as I would any other time. And I'm gonna do my go-to makeup look. So, like I said earlier, this is gonna be really light. I'm so afraid. But we're gonna have to make it work. You guys see that? It's not my shade at all. Okay, so it has a very weird smile, like clinical smile to it. Yeah, no. It doesn't smell good, but it's foundation. It doesn't need to smell good, it just needs to look good. Okay, so one thing I'm gonna do is one side I'm gonna apply with a beauty sponge and the other side I'm gonna use a brush. It says at the back of the bottle, mattifies and blurs pores for a shine-free finish, buildable coverage for normal to oily skin, and it says shake well before use. So the coverage is buildable, so we're gonna see. Okay, so it dries pretty quickly. Me stopping and being on the phone and like reading the back of the bottle is making it a bit harder to blend out, but obviously that's my fault. Okay, so that's like 2 layers of application. Oh my gosh, on camera I look ghostly. Oh my gosh. I'm just gonna use a stippling brush for the side of my face. Obviously this is not hygienic at all, but I'm the only one who's gonna use this foundation. The applicator of it is like a spatula. It doesn't come in a pump. I suppose you can pour it out onto your hand, but I just use that spatula to apply it directly to my face. Obviously with a brush it's much more full coverage because brushes do not soak up the product, and I'm also pushing it into my skin, so the coverage is going to be way better than that of the beauty sponge, which is damp. A lot of dark marks around. You guys, each time I look at the viewfinder on the camera on the screen, I just like, what the hell is going on? I feel like this is okay. No, I'm not gonna be negative, it's not a fail. Maybe I can pull this around, but it's so light. Like, this is not my shade at all. I have to do a lot of contouring to bring this together. Okay, this side has only been one layer and this side it's 2 layers, and this side is less coverage than using the brush. So I think I'm just gonna do the rest of my face using the brush, because I mean, if we're already looking pasty and white like this, we might as well commit and do it all over our face and do a proper job. Yo, you guys. You guys, okay, so first things first, obviously this shade is way too light for me. But let's try to look past that, you guys. Let's try to look at how the foundation itself performed outside of the shade. Okay, so like I said earlier, this side of the face, yo, I just cannot take myself seriously. Okay, so this side of the face, it looks much better, much more fuller coverage, as opposed to this side of the face, because this side of the face I use my beauty sponge and this side I use the brush. So right now it does not look dry, nor does it look like it's matte, but I suppose it's because I applied this and I was pretty generous with it. So that's that. And it is creasing already, it's creasing underneath my eyes and I'm starting to crease around my mouth as well. I feel like the coverage is really buildable, because initially when I applied just one layer on one side, it was pretty light, but then when I added another layer, it really did build up just a little bit, but the sponge still soaked up a huge part of it. Right now I wouldn't look at it and be like, oh my gosh, this looks flawless, but I suppose having the incorrect shade does play a huge role in that. It's gonna be quite hard for me to do a proper job of judging when I look like this. Okay, so I think maybe once I've applied my contour and I've tried to balance out the rest of my face, I might feel a little bit better about it. But so far I actually like it. I really like this side especially, and like I said earlier, the Nivea did play a huge role in the finish of the look. But I actually like that. Like, I don't like my foundations being too dry, especially in summer. Like, I know in summer we like to go for a matte foundation because there's just so much heat and our skin starts producing natural oils. But for me, I still like to keep my dewy look. If I feel like I need to go in with powder because I'm starting to get too oily, then I'd rather do that as opposed to leaving the house with a dry, matte looking face. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the rest of my face. I'm gonna contour. I usually don't contour, but I feel like in order for us to do somewhat of a decent job today, a contour is really needed, okay? Because we cannot be going around like this. And I need to go somewhere after this, so I need to pull it together. So I'm gonna do the rest of my face and then I'm gonna come back on camera for you guys, okay? Okay, you guys, so this is my finished makeup look. I feel like I really did a great job bringing that color in and making it match me way better than it did initially. And I didn't use any concealer because my face was already way too light. I just used a bit of contour and a whole lot of bronzer and blush, and every day is lip line and pink gloss vibes. Like, literally every single day is pink lip gloss vibes over here. So let me just go back to the page so that we can see what the foundation, rather we can remind ourselves what the foundation claimed to do. Okay, it says your skin only better. Okay, so it really does look like my skin. Like, it's so lightweight looking and it feels very lightweight. Like, my face doesn't feel heavy even though I applied quite a lot of it. Like, initially before I went in with the rest of my makeup routine, it looked like quite a lot, but now, girl, like, look at this. It looks so beautiful. Like, it has blended in quite nicely. It's sitting on my skin so beautifully. Like, it has really just been a moment. It has really become the moment that it needed to become. What do I say? Okay, let me do a better job of being more articulate. It really does look better, you guys. Like, initially when I applied it, I was a bit scared, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I was a lot scared after I had applied it, but after I did the rest of my face, it looks so beautiful. Like, places where there aren't really any other products but the foundation, like over here and the center of my forehead. It looks so beautiful. It does not look cakey or a lot, even though it's a full even though it's like a matte foundation. So I'm quite happy about that. And you guys, okay, so this foundation is mostly focused on how it performs on film, on camera. So you guys are the ones that can actually see how it looks, because right now I'm just seeing myself in the mirror. I can see myself a little bit on the screen, but it's a bit too far and my eyesight is not so good. I can only really judge afterwards. Then maybe I'll come back later on at around 9 o'clock and see how I think I looked on camera. So you guys, comment down below what you guys think. Like, how does it look as the person who's watching? Because right now I'm just looking at myself in the mirror and I have to say I'm very happy with what I'm seeing. So the part about it performing really well under lighting, I'll be able to judge after I've watched this clip. So which means later on when I come back for the time weight test. Okay, so one thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to take a picture using my phone and I'm gonna flash myself and then I'm gonna see how it looks. Okay, so you guys, oh my god, okay, so I'm using my front camera, right? And I can get it to flash, but I really wanna use the back camera. But on my camera, on my front camera right now, it looks so bomb. Like, I'm using my phone and I have a pretty old iPhone, like iPhone 6. So we can't really say like the technology is making it look good or is making me look good. Like, this is like a pretty old iPhone, but I look so beautiful. Like, I look so perfect. Like, it really is looking perfect and my face looks so perfect. Okay, so I'll just insert the picture on screen. Okay, so now I'm gonna take with the rear camera and I'm gonna flash myself and hopefully I'll do a good job. Okay, wait, I'm just gonna use this mirror over here. Yo, it looks so good. Oh my gosh, it really delivers. It does not look like, there's no white cast, even though it was pretty light, so I'm really impressed by that. There is no flashback, there is no white cast or anything crazy like that. Like, you guys, I'm so impressed with this foundation and I feel like it looks so beautiful. Like, when I'm looking at myself in the mirror, like in real life now, not just on camera, and there aren't any filters or anything like that, I just feel like I look so good. And having like all the products on top of the foundation, it doesn't look like too layered or too cakey or like there's so much going on. You guys, okay, so for me, this is definitely a thumbs up, like for sure. Like, now I just need to go out there and get myself the proper foundation shade. So you guys, I'm just gonna go somewhere right now. Like I said, the time is 5 o'clock. And then after like 3 hours, 4 hours, I'm gonna come back on camera. I know that's not a very long time, but I started the video pretty late, so I'm sorry about that. I'm just gonna come back when the time is right, like 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, and I'll give you guys my final thoughts on how the foundation wore out, and you guys will actually get to see how it lasted throughout. Like, look at that. Like, look at that. You guys, this foundation is a bomb. Like, yes, I'm feeling like, yes, this is the foundation. I just need to get my shade, but other than that, I'm so happy. Okay, you guys, I'll see you later. Hi, you guys. So I am back. The time now is 23:46. I've actually been sleeping for the past 3 hours, I think so. What time did I fall asleep? Been sleeping for the past 4 hours. I think I probably passed out like 8:30. Now it's almost 12 o'clock. Let me take off my hair because maybe that's a bit distracting. I obviously slept facing upwards. I actually smudged my face right over there. I'm not sure what happened. I think maybe I probably touched myself while I was sleeping. However, the rest of my face is still sitting. Like, you guys, I'm so impressed with this foundation. And it really does look perfect. Like, I understand why they were saying the people it was tested on described it as like picture perfect. It's like a like you look like you have a filter on. Of course, I'm creasing around my mouth. But I actually noticed that after I started eating, but before that I was completely fine. But obviously I'm creasing around my mouth, and that's actually about it. This doesn't count because this happened when I was sleeping, so it doesn't really count. It's just my mouth, like around the lines around my mouth, and that's it. The rest of my face still looks perfect, literally the way that it looked after I had finished. Initially, I'm trying to find the majority of the study participants said that the resulting picture was no flashback or flawless, yes, or perfect. Like, they're not lying. And you guys can also like judge for yourselves. I mean, you guys can see how good I look. Let me try to zoom in. This is me after like 4 hours. No, like I think 6 hours. Wait, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, it's like after 6 hours of having the makeup on. Period. I definitely recommend that you guys go out and get this product. So I feel like that's pretty much it for this video. I've done the wear test. And I have done like the flashback test, and you guys can see how it looks in me after some time. And I am definitely giving this foundation a big thumbs up. If you guys are interested, you guys can go get it. I bought mine from Clicks, but I'm pretty sure you can also get it from Discam. It's 130, guys. That's so affordable. So if you guys are looking for a good, affordable foundation, this is one to go for. Like, genuinely, the other foundations that I have are around the 200 range, 200 rands range. So this is actually one of the cheapest foundations I have that is very full coverage. So you guys can go get one for yourselves. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to like, subscribe, and comment down below. I'll see you guys on the next one, and thank you so much for watching.